chains. I get through the pain. Taste sweet on my. I got an antidote to retain some kind of self-control. Look inside my head through a telescope. You erased all the calls from a telephone. No sense of smell, maybe tell a joke. Holding back your tears, singing minimal syllables. Yo, look at me, at the asylum. Was a fate or mistake, cause the time ain't up. Yet the parts of my mind don't get much love. If you want in my head, come on, call me up. You look like a twisted Robin Hood. Yeah, you take from the rich and the poor and us. Wearing diamond shoes where you walk your pugs. In a town you create where there ain't no love.
Where do I go?
But still got a reflux. I drip out from the socket, so a teacup. Drink up inside. Look when they peep us. Jesus in
the. It's the National Football League presented by EA Sports. The Hab will decide the second entrant to next week's NFC title game, as we've got a great one in store between the New York Giants and the Los Angeles Rams. Punch the fourth and final ticket to the conference championship round. We'll know soon enough as we are underway here on a January afternoon. First carry for Cam Akers. This will be stopped about 2 yards shy of the marker. 8 yard gain, second and two.
That was a really nice job by them picking up the run blitz and detecting it and blocking it and turning it into a nice run. And a lot of times you think if you blitz a running play, you're going to smother it. But a lot of the blitzers, they come in a little bit high. They don't have great leverage and they're easily blocked and turned to the side.
Here's a second and two now from the 33. And now the Giants will stop play as they take a timeout defensively. They'll have two remaining as we step aside here in this first quarter. Ahead of the chains now, second and two. On the ground, it's Akers. Doing. He's immediately taken down at the line of scrimmage.
The ball carrier.
He got maybe a half yard at most, but officially they'll be left with a third and two.
Makes it third and two.
An early test. Two plays in. This is third and two. Touchback
at their own 25-yard line.
Mm-hmm. Jones and the Giants now with a first and 10 at their own 25-yard line. And not much to speak of. Call it a one-yard gain up to the 26.
Well, it's hard to have vision as a runner and find a hole when there's nothing but defenders in your way. They stacked that one up really well. But give him credit. Instead of trying to bounce it out and turn it into a big play, which might have turned into a big loss, Kai just took his medicine there and took the 1 yard.
Here's second and 9, just a yard on that last run. Complete, and he maybe makes it back to the line of scrimmage. That's it. No gain that time on the completion, and it'll be third down. And it looks like we've got a dime set here defensively. Six DBs in the game. Throwing Jones. Here as he's taken down. Samson Abuka gets to him well behind the line of scrimmage. That is a loss of 17 yards. Dixon, the punter, is on as he sends it away. And that one didn't accomplish a whole lot. It'll be down inside the 35-yard line.
The Rams take over first and 10 at the 33-yard line.
So they'll come up first and 10 now from the 33. They'll run it for the first time with Alvin Kamara. And he'll lose yardage on the play back at the 37-yard line.
He's brought down.
That's going to go as a loss of 4, and it'll be second down.
Tackle made back at the 37-yard line.
The Giants, they get the officials' attention and take another timeout. And that's their second charge timeout here in this first quarter. They're down to 1 remaining. Now a shotgun snap as they'll look to throw. That's complete to his tight end, Higbee. And they'll get this one down to about the 20-yard line. His first reception of the divisional round matchup, but it's good for a first down as well. Right after the turnover, they come out throwing.
And that means it's a sudden change situation. We used to practice it on defense. Sudden change, get out there, stop the offense. But you typically run out there a little bit unsettled. I think that's why he came right out throwing the football, hoping to catch him off balance.
And he did. Sit on this one. That'll be a touchback.
At their own 25-yard line.
The Giants offense at the line, ready to begin their next drive. They trail early on the road in the playoffs. Not a great combination as they've got it first and 10. Eluding the pressure right. And incomplete as he was knocked as he threw it. Took the ball off course.
They're bringing a lot of pressure here already in the first quarter. Already sacked him once. Now they get in there and knock another one away.
I think maybe that Tucker rule being gone makes defenses a lot bolder.
Yes, indeed. That time, lucky that the arm was going forward. Incomplete pass. And he's upended at the 33 following a good pickup of 8. And that looked like some pretty easy yardage there right up the gut.
And he's a guy that has some height to him. So when you don't have to drop a shoulder or create or get through contact or trash, makes it a lot easier to stay upright, see the field, and make a run as we just saw there.
From the shotgun now, here's an inside kill. And he's got the first before he's brought down at the 39-yard line. Give him the third down conversion, 5 yards on the play.
And the Giants first down.
So from the 39 now, they'll come up on a first and 10. Nowhere to go that time. He maybe got a yard up to the 40.
Well, sometimes you just have to give credit to the defense. Great job there at the point of attack, holding up. They won their battles at the line of scrimmage, left him no space to try and run. Really nice job swarming to the ball carrier.
Now they try the right side here. And he is met quickly in the backfield. Down he goes, folded like a lawn chair. It's a loss of a yard, so it's back to 3rd and 10.
Third down.
Nothing the score. This is the NFL on EA Sports.
14, Giants nothing.
The threat of a second straight punt to start the game is looming as they come up 3rd and 10. From the gun, Jones. Into heavy traffic and it's intercepted. Taylor Rapp with a pick. Turn this ball across midfield to the 47-yard line.
And that's a great example of ball skills right there, partner. You and I do a lot of games, and I can't tell you how many guys look to run with the football before they've intercepted it. So that's a nice job of focusing on the task at hand and coming away with the interception.
They'll run on first down with Akers. 3 yards on the pickup there, and it'll be second down.
Yeah, I don't know if it's exactly a win-win, but if you're on offense, you'll take that kind of a run, all right? It was kind of stacked up, found a little bit of yardage, and frankly, they're pretty close to staying on schedule on offense. The playbook is still open for the coordinator.
The last run got 3. Now here's 2nd and 7. They'll set up a throw. They'll get this one to Kopp, complete. Trying! And he's taken down, but not before reaching the 10-yard line. He'll get 34 yards there.
I don't think anyone would argue that having that extra week definitely helps come playoff time. And those were some fresh legs right there. That extra practice time and planning, certainly in evidence.
So now, following the big play, they've got a 1st and goal all the way down at the 10. They'll run here with Akers. And the Rams are going to have it 1st and goal as he'll take this down to about the 3.
And there we saw one of the downsides of blitzing during a rundown, because sometimes you get out of your gaps. You don't fit the run quite as well because you're headed towards the ball carrier with abandon.
So the ball position now at the 3. Here's 2nd and goal. They'll run it with Kamara. And he gets halfway home from the 4 down to the 2-yard line. Two straight shots on the ground. Now on 3rd, do you go to the air?
I think the possibility exists, and if you're doing it, you're probably going play action since you ran it twice. But I often think that 2nd down is a time you go play action, throw the ball. I say commit to the run.
He's got it. It's Higbee. Touchdown, Rams. 2 yards on the touchdown there. And the Rams add on to their lead. But boy, So if you are scoring at home, Charles, and God bless you if you are, but that's now three drives and three touchdowns.
So in a baseball game, wouldn't that wreak havoc on your scorecard?
Yes.
I mean, with all the action that's happening now, how they got here, whatever cliche you want to bring into it, they're locked into a groove, they're clicking on all cylinders. Bottom line, they're piling up the points.
At their own 25-yard line.
The Giants offense at the line, ready to begin their next drive. And they're in an early hole. The first drive, they threw the interception. That led to a touchdown. So, decent-sized deficit early on.
It is, but I think you hit the key words, early on. So they have to decide, do we even need to change game plan? Or do we just need to execute better and try and get back in this game?
At the 25-yard line.
Officially nothing on that last run. They'll try again, second and 10. Now a handoff here to his running back. And he's going to be dropped following a pickup of 7 past the 30 to the 32.
That was a good run, and it got to the second level. And what I mean by that is that's where the linebackers usually play, first level being the defensive front, last level being the secondary. But the strong safety position ended up making the tackle. And oftentimes, we call them a hybrid, combination defensive back, combination linebacker. We saw the linebacker make the stop.
The Giants on third down, just 1 for 3 thus far. This time, it's 3rd and 3. Operating from the gun, Jones. He's going to find his man out of the backfield. That's complete. And how about the call here? They need 2 yards in their own territory on fourth down, and they're going to go for it.
2 yards on the play. Brings up fourth down.
They're going to try and throw. Flushed out right. He can run for it, and he will. Yeah, he's going to be out of bounds, but not before he takes it inside the 40. 27 yards, a big play there on fourth. The last drive, remember, similar situation. He forced a ball into coverage through the pick. He learned better there.
Yeah, similar to a golfer that's confronted with a shot that you just can't make. Sometimes you have to take your medicine, as they say, right? Just pull it down, take off, and go. Don't make something worse than what it was.
Second quarter action, 2 minutes to go on divisional round weekend. We remind you, as we've done all year, that coming up at halftime, we will visit with Jonathan Coachman, standing by at Orlando. He'll let you know what's going on here on a very eventful divisional round weekend. Inside the 20. That's how you drop the run pass option right there. You get a chunk play out of it.
And you know quarterbacks love to throw the RPOs because oftentimes they're in breaking routes, but receivers love it even more. The ball gets to them quickly, allows them to put some moves on in the secondary.
Looking for his running back, and he's got him. And he's able to break out of one tackle, but then quickly brought down. A good rally to the football keeps him to only a yard, and it's second down.
At the 15-yard line.
And they'll get this out quickly to Gilmore. And this play gets blown up. They'll lose yardage back at the 17. They wind up losing a couple there, so they go behind the original line of scrimmage. And now 3rd and 11 coming up. Seventh play of this drive coming up, but a long way to go on third down. Now Jones. Flush to his right. The scramble good for a nice gain of 10 yards, but still fourth down.
I like this effort there. He got it done on his own. But let's face it, he puts defenses in a really stressful spot when he takes off and runs because a lot of guys have coverage responsibilities.
Good job of rallying, though, because I thought when he first took off, he might pick up the first down. The offense here not budging. They're going to fight for him on 4th and inches. And he's able to pick up the first before he's brought down inside the 5 at the 4. So the decision to go for it turns out to be a good one. They get a couple of yards, and as a result, the drive keeps moving. It's now 1st and goal. line of scrimmage. Again, the 4-yard line. Second and goal. From the shotgun now, here's an inside give. And he gets halfway there from the 4 to the 2 on a gain of 2. After getting stuffed on first down, not much better there. 2-yard gain. And now they come up and spike it to start the clock. So with 2 ticks left here in the half, on is the field goal unit. From the right hash at a bit of a tight angle. Badgley's kick is good. So we've come upon halftime here in this NFC divisional round matchup. As we send you to our EA studios in Orlando, here's Jonathan Coachman with our EA Sports Halftime Report. A trip to the NFC title game hanging in the balance. Second half action back underway. Fielded near the back of the end zone. And Ballantyne going to sit on this one. That'll be a touchback. The Giants offense at the line, ready to begin their next drive. And tough to win games if you're going field goal, field goal, field goal here. They got field goal last time. Now they'll be looking for a touchdown.
Looking for the big chunk now because, as you noted, the field goal, field goal, field goal way of doing it makes it that much harder and puts more pressure on every possession for you now. Go ahead and get 6 and feel a lot more comfortable about the position they're in.
Bigger chunks. We'll see if they can get the score. Giants. So how about that for a chain mover? They're all the way down inside the 40 now for 1st and 10. From the gun, Jones. His throw caught at about the 5. And he will take it on in for a Giant touchdown.
Touchdown, New York.
Evan Engram, 36 yards. And the Giants are able to draw a bit closer.
The kick is good.
And he's able to put it through.
Makes the score Rams 21, Giants 10.
Now after the touchdown, ready to boot it away, Riley Dixon. And no return on this one as the fair catch is signaled for and taken.
The Rams take over 1st and 10 at their own 25-yard line.
Set to begin their next drive, the Rams offense at the line. Their lead down to 2 scores after the touchdown a moment ago as they start with a 1st and 10. And this has been a familiar sight all afternoon as they stop him behind the line. 2 yards the loss, 2nd and 12.
Brings up 2nd and 12 at the 23-yard line.
First play of the drive goes the wrong way. Here's 2nd and 12. From the shotgun, he'll look to throw. Open man, Higby, the tight end. And down he goes, but he takes it up to the 40. It's a pickup of 17 and a 1st down.
1st and 10 at the 40-yard line.
And that play went nowhere. Losing yardage. It'll be back at the 36. That'll wind up going for a loss of 4. And that's going to make it 2nd and 14. To throw. Out of the backfield, that's complete to Kamara. It's a 4-yard pickup, and that's going to lead to a 3rd and 11.
That's a good job there by the corner. We do talk about this a lot, that a lot of corners see their job as simply covering receivers. Tackling isn't everyone's thing, but in this case, he came up quickly and made a nice, sure tackle.
And the Giants will go with 6 defensive backs here on 3rd. Now they'll throw here, out of the gun. Hit as he throws there, incomplete.
And those two just haven't been in sync thus far. They've done a nice job against him, but still, with his talent, you would expect them to have more completions to him in this game.
On is the punter, Hecker, as he gets this one away.
First and 10 at their own 14-yard line.
The Giants offense at the line, ready to begin their next drive. I guess they have to feel a little gratified to at least get on the board last time, but still work to do.
No doubt about it. I wonder now if they're going to try to increase the urgency a little bit, maybe pump up the pace, maybe go 2 minutes. Who knows? Let's see what they decide to do.
He's going to air one out, and that will be incomplete. Would have been a big hitter if they had connected. Instead, it's second down.
Another attempt, another incompletion, and when I look at the scoreboard and where we are in this game, it comes to mind that they have to start getting the ball in the hands of their playmakers. Throw it to the guys that maybe can take a short pass and turn it into a long game or make people miss downfield. They've got to have points, and the guys who can put the ball in the end zone, they're the ones that need to touch the ball.
Give it here to his running back. They do get a yard there, but only a yard. Leaves him with third and nine looming.
Well, that's a good start to this drive on the defensive side of the ball.
Force the incompletion on first down. Then you're able to shut down the running play on second.
Yeah, I wouldn't be surprised now. A little bit of pressure going at the quarterback in the expected passing situation.
This offense in desperate need of a conversion as they come up on third down. Just 1 second showing on the play clock. We're going to get a timeout. It's just their first, so two remaining as they burn one here in this third quarter. The Rams go nickel here defensively on third. Looking to throw. Jones. Deep ball for Goodwin. He's got a man. Complete. Touchdown, Giants. Marquise Goodwin. 84 yards. And the Giants have got it back to a one-score game. Well, this offense only mustered 3 points in the first half on that field goal. They picked up the pace now. 2 third-quarter touchdowns.
Hey, you remember that appearance we had last week in front of that crowd, and they asked about halftime adjustments and all that was going on. And remember what I said? It's not always an adjustment at halftime. Sometimes.
Now Jones has hit. He lost the football. And the Rams have got it. Going the other way. He's at the 50. He's at the 30. And can you believe this? It's 2 points the other way on the fumble return.
Rams 23. Giants.
Now after the touchdown, ready to boot it away, Riley Dixon. And a fair catch signaled for and taken successfully.
The Rams take over first and 10 at their own 25-yard line.
Set to begin their next drive, the Rams offense at the line. And they've got the lead here getting late into the third quarter. And the passing game for them, it's been terrific. We've seen that, but the rushing game almost non-existent.
And with the lead and trying to finish this game off, they need the running game to come back to life. They need to get sparked that way, take some time off the clock, and keep the ball away from their opponents.
They'll break the huddle, come up on second and 8 at the 27-yard line. this up to the 40-yard line before being corralled. His first reception of the divisional round matchup, but it's good for a first down as well.
40-yard line.
That's the reason we ball for. Circle round twice with the encore. You know, you know.
Final minute now of the third quarter. On first down, Akers. He's across the 40 to the 41. In the first half, he was held in check on the ground, but despite that lack of production, they still have the lead.
Yeah, and they've got to feel fortunate about that. If they can actually get production from their lead horse, that would help open up this offense and widen this margin, too.
The last run good for two. Here's second and eight. Going right back to Akers. And very little daylight there. He'll get a couple up to the 44.
Ball carrier. The tackle made at the 44-yard line. A 2-yard pickup brings up third and six.
One quarter remains for a trip to the NFC title game. We'll return with more after this. This is the NFL, and it's on EA Sports. The Rams on third down. They've been okay, 2 for 3 thus far. This will be third and six. He'll look to throw. And able to find Higbee. It's complete. And he's going to have a Rams first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. The Rams, they are on the move. They've got another first down.
At the 38-yard line.
They'll run on first down. Akers. Touchdown, Allen! Cam Akers, his second touchdown of the afternoon. And the Rams tack on to their advantage.
Apparently the week off hasn't hurt him one bit. 1,000-yard rush in the regular season, get his first touchdown here in the playoffs. Perhaps the week off energized him.
A great article in the paper this morning basically saying that they would not have won the division without him, and he's not their only piece, but I think that's a fair statement.
It's easy to say it this way. He's their main counter.
Extra point right down the middle, and the lead now up to 14.
30, Giants 16.
The kickoff unit is out on the field, and they will send this one away. And this carries into the end zone. And only able to get this to the 19, so probably should have opted for the touchback.
The Giants take over first and 10 at their own 19-yard line.
The Giants offense at the line, ready to begin their next drive. And this could be the defining moment of their season, all hyperbole aside. You're trailing here in the fourth quarter, the divisional round. They need to come up with something as they get this drive started. There to make the tackle, Samson Abuka. Well done to sniff that out defensively. He had it diagnosed pretty quickly.
I love that description because diagnosed is perfect on that one. Read his keys, made the play, and he couldn't even get going moving the football.
Throwing on second down, Jones. And the pass is intercepted. He was looking for Ingram. Jones picked off at the 30.
Partner, we always talk about possessions being at a premium in these games, and now in this situation, throwing an interception here when you have to claw your way back in, that one's going to hurt, and in a big way.
So, first and 10 now from the 30. Here's Akers. McLennard Williams there on the stop. Got to figure now, after getting that turnover, they're just going to be happy to keep the ball on the ground, right?
This is where covering the football, taking care of the ball, all the ball security terms have ever been used, they come into play for the guys on offense right now. Just take care of it, and they've got a good chance of ending up winning this game.
So now it's third and long, because remember, they also lose a down on the grounding call. They'll run this with Akers. Oh, he's got a little daylight. And he'll be brought down at the 27-yard line. They get 13 yards, but not enough for the first down due to the previous penalty. They had quite a hole to dig out of there on third and long. Not able to get the first, but a pretty good size run.
A really good run, but how much confidence do you have in your next play call that you can sell to the head coach? Let's go get it on fourth down. Do you really have a play you believe in, or are you just hopeful? And you've got to sell it to the big man before it gets called.
So with that, you figure this game's pretty much out of reach at this point.
Yeah, it's going to take a heck of a comeback to come from three scores down. But don't change that channel. Don't go away. Miracles can happen, and you want to be here in case it does.
You're a company man.
Now, aren't I, though?
The Giants offense at the line, ready to begin their next drive. Their hopes of advancing past this divisional round hanging by a thread, if that, as they begin here with a first and 10 on the wrong side of the scoreboard. A nice pickup there of 11 yards, and it'll move the sticks.
Despite the score, despite the deficit, no quitting this guy. He's running angry, running through arm tackles. He wants to change what that scoreboard is saying.
Fake here on first down. And down he goes on the pressure from the Rams defense. Samson Abukum picks up his second sack of the afternoon. Well, they go play fake. The problem is nobody was faked out.
And when no one's faked out, what's the end result? Quarterback gets hit.
They'll come up after the sack on a second and 12. Now they'll run it on the toss. They'll rumble for about five, up close to the 40.
On a second and long, it's really nice to see an offense that has enough confidence to run the football in that situation. I think that goes back to their practice and game planning. They've seen things that they've seen on tape and in previous games that led them to believe that even in a long-distance situation, they can still run the football and gain enough yardage to put themselves in a good spot on third down.
So it's Giants football here as we welcome you back. And let's see what they've come up with offensively after having time to talk it over. Here's Jones. Third down. Jones in trouble here, and down he goes. Samson Abukum able to disrupt yet another pass play. That is his third sack of the afternoon.
And it's fourth down.
All right, they're going to try and keep hope alive here on fourth down. They're going for it. That's going to set them back 5 yards. And they're indeed going to go for it here on fourth down. So trailing here in the last quarter, let's see how this plays out. Got to try it here. He's back to throw. And this is caught. A spectacular one-handed grab there. They had to go for it with such little time remaining. And as a result, their playoff run may end right here. So here's a first and 10 at the 38. The defense can stop it twice more as they take a knee here. The defense can stop it twice more as they take a knee here. So time to start going in the other direction as they come up now, third and long.
Today's final score.
And they have secured a spot in the conference championship, and now you can start to smell it at this point in the season, can't you?
You really can, because the focus has been one game at a time, not looking ahead. But when you get to the conference championship game and you know you're there, the Super Bowl does loom in the future.
So that's a wrap. For Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gunn. And this has been a presentation of the NFL on EA Sports. For more, check us out at EA Sports.
They don't know my name. I get through the pain. Taste sweet on my face like it's lemonade. Tie me up in chains. I get through the pain. Taste sweet on my face like it's lemonade.
They say fall and you let go, but I know I got an antidote to retain some kind of self-control. Look inside my head. You erase all the calls from my telephone. No sense of smile, maybe tell a joke. Holding back your tears, singing minimal syllables. Yo. Look at me, at the asylum. Was a fatal mistake, cause the time ain't up. Yet the parts of my mind don't get much love. If you want in my head, come on, call me up. You look like a twisted Robin Hood. Yeah, you take from the rich and the poor and us. Wearing diamond shoes while you walk your pugs. In a time you create where there ain't no love.
Where do I go?
Reflux, I drip out from the socket, so a teacup, drink up inside, look when they peep us, Jesus in the belly of the beast, but outside there's a war going on your front lawn, Black Hawk, see the red dawn, horizon, blind yet I'm rising, abiding by laws of attraction, my thoughts still rising, thank you, what type of knowledge don't sink in, life gives you lemons and my only thought is drinking, thirsty, will I be alive or dead before 30, that's all that concerns me early, lemonade quenching my inner rage, when it takes center stage, way before they pouring on my grave, minute made, let it set my soul ablaze, on each and every way, put me in the water for the save.
They don't know my name.
Go ahead, just down like that. Go ahead, just down like that. Like-
like a transport, and I ain't never seen something so round. How round? Round like a planet in orbit, round like a b-ball, 23 Jordan, dunking on default. Automatic forces attract me to females. I look this gorgeous. How did you even come in existence? Hey, I did you just appear out in an instance? You got me all driven, revving my pistons. I wonder if she like the stick shift. Hey, count a four and make a wish.
Wish?
I wish.
What?
That shorty keep it lit. Cause if I shoot my shot, I won't miss. No backboard, gotta sound a light swish.
Go ahead, touch down like that. 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 Hey, hey, go ahead, touch down like that. Go ahead, touch down like that. Go ahead, touch down like that. Go ahead, just down like that, like
work the middle, work the middle, work the middle.